Hey, hi Kavita.
Hi.
Okay, so I guess I'm audible to each one of you now. Okay, so just let's start with the session for today. Okay, so today we'll be learning in detail about the software development life cycle. But before going into the detail of that, do you remember we have discussed about this thing in the demo class? What is the software development life cycle is? Anyone who wants to share their thoughts on this one? We have discussed about not in detail, but still we have discussed about software development life cycle. Anyone who wants to answer about this? Yes. See, try to interact with me, otherwise the session would be too boring. Okay, so whatever you feel like, if you have previous knowledge about it, or you must have heard about, or anything like you know anything about software development lifecycle, those who have attended my demo session, they would be able to, I guess they would be able to know about it. Okay, yes, Kavita. Just a second, I would unmute you. Okay.
Yeah.
Yes, Kavita.
First, the client they have to give their ideas what kind of software they want to develop to the developers, and they will write the coding for that, and the testers, they have to test whether it runs correctly or not. Then after correcting all the mistakes and all things, they have to release the product to the clients. I think that is the software development lifecycle.
Okay. There are some more things that needs to be done. Okay. So, but still, I would appreciate that you took the initiative and gave the answer since no one was interested in giving the answers. See, I would again say make the session interactive, please. Okay. Now, otherwise, on my responsibility, what I'll do, I'll teach you the things. But if you are taking interest in that, so might be you can take out more from me. Okay? So it's totally up to you. Okay. So those who have even not attended the demo session, not a problem. We are again going to discuss about the software development lifecycle. And today we are going to discuss in detail about the things. Now, what exactly a software development lifecycle means is a cycle through which a software needs to be, like if you have to develop a software, so what all are the phases that needs to be covered, okay? And what all things needs to be done in order to build a proper software. So that cycle is known as the software development life cycle. Now over here, we have some phases which we have already discussed, okay? So we'll be discussing a bit more detail about the phases, but with that, we are also going to discuss today that what is exactly done in each of this phase. Okay, so I would make prepare separate columns for that. Okay, then apart from that, who all are the people who would be involved in a phase, in that particular phase, and then what all are the documents that needs to be prepared. Okay, for each phase there is some or the other document that needs to be prepared. Okay, then there are a set of specialized people who are involved in each phase. So who all will be the people who will be involved and what they are going to do. So this needs to be discussed over here in our session for today. Okay, so the first phase, as Kavita told that the client would be coming, okay, to us who wants a software to be built for his company or for his website or anything, like he wants a software to be built for him. Okay. Now, if he wants a software to be built for him, he needs to give us some or the other requirements. He must be having a set of requirements, right? Now, it is not necessary that the person or the client who is coming up to you, he is a technical person. He is an IT back. He is having some IT background. He could be a common person also. Okay. So as a common person, if he is coming up to your company for asking you to build a software for him, do you think that he would be able to give you some technical specifications, or he would be able to tell you the software, what he wants in technical terms? Do you expect that he would give you some technical things? No. Right, Peter. So, though he would be able to give me the requirements, what he wants, but he won't be able to give me the requirements in the technical format which my IT people would understand, and they could build a software depending upon the technical requirements. Okay. So firstly, what would happen? He would give the requirements in a simple language, okay, in which he understands the things. Okay. And then those requirements needs to be converted into the technical things, into the technical specifications, which is understood by the IT people. So don't you think that you need a mediator in between who can convert the requirement of the clients into the technical specifications which are understood by your IT people who are going to develop the software, or who are going to test the software, or who are going to do some more things in the software? Yes. So you need a mediator in between who could who could tell the or who could convert the technical specifications, the client specification, into the technical one. Okay. So for that, the person or the specialized group of person over there who are going to do this job are known as the BA people, or you can also say them as the business analyst. Okay. So first phase would be your requirement gathering phase. Okay. Now what is done in this phase? The business requirements are taken down. And who is involved in this phase? The BA people. Okay. Because they are going to gather the requirement from the clients, and they are going to gather the business requirement, and at that time they are going to convert it into the technical specifications. Now, while converting them into the technical format, they will be preparing a document. Okay. And that document is known as the BRD. Or you can also say it as the business requirement that is BRD, and the business requirement document. Okay. Now then, once the business requirements are ready, now the things can go into your IT project team. Okay. Now your people would be the group of people, or your team would be able to understand the set of requirements which are given by your clients. So now, okay, let us take a simple example to understand this thing. Okay, you all have used the Gmail application, right? Have you all used the Gmail application, or yes, the Gmail application only. We can take the example of Gmail application only. Okay, so what happens over there? Suppose say my client wants a similar application to be built for him. He wants a application to be built for him wherein the people could log in into their account. Okay, now once they have successfully logged in into the account, then they could get in their mails, check the mails that they have got, or they could also send the mails to some other people. Okay, this is what my client wants to be there in his software. Okay, so in his simple terms, he had said that I want a software to be built for me wherein the people can log in into the account and they can check their mails and can send their mails to the persons whom they want to. Okay, now it is the responsibility of the business analyst people that they prepare a document wherein they jot down all the requirement of the clients, and not only jotting down the requirements, they would convert the requirement, the simple language requirement, into the technical requirements. Now what do you mean by converting a simple language requirement into a technical requirement is, see, client won't be telling you that I want my user should be authorized user, okay, his password should match his user ID, then he should be able to log in. Then after login, he should be able to see a page wherein he could see all the mails. The recent mails should be on the top. Okay, there should be a search bar. He won't be able to tell you all these things because he is a non-technical person. Okay, these all things are taken down by your BA people. Okay, so in the business requirement document, these all things are written down. Okay, that there should be an inbox, then after that there should be some things, or there should be a link wherein the people could go and then they could send mail option. Okay, so these all things are written down into the business requirement document. Now then after that comes the second phase. Now that phase is known as your planning phase. Okay, planning, or you can also say it as the design phase. Now what would happen over here in the planning or the design phase? Once the business requirement or the BRD is ready, then after that you again go back to the client, okay, asking him whether the document which you have prepared is according to his requirements, it is covering up all his requirements or not, or if he wants something more to be added in that. Okay, now once he said yes to your document, then you can go ahead to the later on phases. Now what is done in this planning and design phase? Once the document is being approved, then depending upon this document, you have to give your client a deadline. That, see, you have given us a software which is having these many requirements. Suppose say some set of 10 requirements are there. Okay, we have a set of 10 requirements for which we need like a month. Okay, so we'll give him a deadline that we would be completing this software, these set of 10 requirements in 1 month. Okay, so over here in the planning phase, we are going to plan that how you are going to, or how much time is needed to complete the requirements that are written in the BRD. And in planning, you also will have to consider that not only you have to build the software in 1 month, you also will have to calculate the time for testing also. Okay, so how much time would be, so all estimations are done. Okay, so over here the scheduling would be done, that how much time would be needed. Apart from that, you also will have to calculate the budget. Okay, so if you are going to complete a set of 10 requirements, then you should give a budget that we need this much of budget for this set of requirements. And if you now increase the requirements, then the budget would go on increasing and also the time would increase. Okay, so all budgeting and scheduling, the things, these all things are done in your planning and the design phase. Now apart from that, see, scheduling and budget is done, But one more thing is important over here, wherein the top management people would be involved. Okay, now what is that? As I have already told you, see, your client wants only a simple software to be built wherein he should log in. Okay, he said that I should be able to, not I, the persons should be able to log in into the account. They should be able to check their mails. They should be sent some mails. They should be able to send some mails, and then they should log out properly. Now, don't you think that before giving this document or before giving this requirements to your coders, some high level designing needs to be done? As in the case of, as we have discussed earlier, like if you want to build a home, okay, so if I'm giving my requirement, I need a person who should be able to do some blueprint or the high level design depending upon my requirements, right? If I want some 3 BHK or 4 BHK, some 2 garage space should be there, kitchen should be there, finished basement should be there. So all these things needs to be first print, or a blueprint of all these requirements should be firstly given to the client. Okay, so for that, apart from the scheduling and budgeting over here in this, one more things needs to be done, that is the HLD. Now what is HLD? That is the high level design. Okay, so we call it as a high level design also. Okay, now who is going to do this high level design and the scheduling and the budgeting and all everything? This is done by your project manager, and also for the designing purposes you will also need an architect. Okay, so these all are the people who would be involved in this phase of planning and designing. Okay, now see, budget not only includes that how many people or how much money you would be needing. Budgeting also depends upon if you are going to use some tools for building the software or for testing the software. Okay, so those tools are licensed tools which you are using or which you would be using later on. Okay, so for those license you need to buy those tools. So over here in the budgeting portion you have to include that thing also, and then only you can give a rough estimate to your client that we would charge you this much. Okay, then how many people you would include in this particular software to build and to test? So if you're including a team of say 10 people, okay, so you have to pay them. So that all things are also included in your budget. Then you have to take some extra money also if in case the things goes wrong. Okay, then you have to extend the time. Okay, so if you're extending the time, then you have to pay your team for that. Okay, or if you are using some extra softwares which you have previously not thought of. Okay, so all those estimations are done and then only you can give a budget. Similar in the case of scheduling also. See, for scheduling it is not that you will give, like, my development team would need 20 days to build this 10 requirements, then my testing team would take some 7 days to test the software. Okay, I have to take out some buffer time also. What if any of the testers, they are not available? Okay, who's going to do the testing? If I have in testers team, I have only 2 or 3 people. Okay, and due to some or the other reason, 2 people are not available. So the time would get extended. Okay, or maybe the testing environment is not ready. Now what is testing environment and all, we will discuss later on. But the things that you want to be ready or suppose say my development team in 20 days they are not able to build the software due to some or the other reasons, because the requirements were very much typical requirements, so they need some extra time. So you have to calculate all those buffer things also, and then only you can give a schedule. Okay, so for that you need some experienced people, so that is why project manager is included in this particular phase. Okay, and for creating the designs you need a technical person, so that would be your architect. He would create the design for you. Okay, now the document over here which is prepared, or in which you are going to jot down all these things, the document is known as your project plan document. Okay, now comes the third phase. Now see, we are ready with the high level design. Okay, then comes the main phase, that is the development phase, wherein the software is going to get developed. Or you can also say as the coding phase. Okay, whatever you want to say. So that would be the development phase, wherein your coders or your programmers are going to get involved. Oh, this should be here. So what they are going to do, they are going to write down the, they are going to develop the software, or you can also also say that they are going to code the software. Okay, then the people would be known as the programmers, and the document or the things that they are going to write down, in technical terms it is known as the source code, or in simple terms you also call it as the programs. Okay, now once the development team have done their job, then comes the testing phase. Now what needs to be done in this testing phase is, we are not going to discuss right now. Okay, but why I'm saying so, we are not going to discuss right now, because there are a lot many things which needs to be done. Okay, in this testing phase, for example, just let me tell you, we have also discussed about STLC who were there in the demo session. Okay, so over there we just have gone through the brief introduction of STLC. So over there, what was the thing, that before testing or while doing the testing, you have to prepare documents, you have to prepare a plan. Okay, that how many testers you would be including in your team. Okay, then after that, who will be doing what type of testing, you are going to assign the roles. Okay, then after preparing the test plan, then you have to write down the test cases. Okay, what were the test cases, the steps that needs to be followed for doing a particular test or for checking a particular functionality, the steps that you need to follow. Okay, so you have to write down the test cases also. Then you have to prepare the test data, that is the dummy data which you need to execute your test cases. Now once you are ready with your test cases and the test data, then you need to execute the test cases, right? Then after that, you have to, after execution of the test cases, then you have to tally that whether your results are matching up with your actual results or not. Okay, so all those things are needed over here. So we have to discuss a lot in detail about all those things. So right now I'm not writing anything over here, because that still needs to be discussed, and we would be discussing it later in the other sessions. So who are